Yeah, hello. I'm trying to leave a message for Dr. Bauer, but there's no answer in his office.
Yeah, I guess he must be around here somewhere. Do you want to hang on? I'll see if I can track him down, okay?
Excuse me, can you please tell me where Dr. St. John's office is?
Yeah, actually, I think I can. You go right down there and make the second left, and then you have to jog right, and then it's on the left-hand side. It's room 427.
Jog right.
Do you need an escort?
No, that's fine. I think I can handle it.
Well, if you need any help, just put your lips together and blow.
Thanks.
You had to find out for yourself, didn't you?
What are you talking about?
You don't have to pretend with me. Mandy's not around. All right, want to know who your parents are?
I know who my parents are. I already told you I'm not taking any damn blood tests.
May I join you?
I've said everything I want to say to you.
You're wrong. We have so much in common. We both resent Alexandra and care very much about Nick.
Yeah, I tailed Thorpe to that place across from the hospital company.
Yeah, well, he's got less than an hour to turn himself in.
I know, sweat. He's just having breakfast with his daughter.
You don't let him out of your sight in case he gets any bright ideas.
Right, no problem.
Don't look at him. It's going to be okay.
Last night after I talked to you, I was really scared that you were going to do something crazy to stop Mom from marrying Daniel.
I was halfway out of town before I realized that it was crazy. I'd just get picked up by the police and be no help to Holly at all. I need some time to think.
What about your deadline?
I have no intention of turning myself in today. I'm going to get your mother away from that lunatic.
Almost forgot. Somebody's in there trying on some winter dud. Glad you said something.
Excuse me. I just want to grab a case of Birch beer. You almost done in there?
Should be by now.
Want to open up?
Isn't answering his page.
Do you have any idea where he might be? Hello?
He could be anywhere right now.
Well, could you give him a message for me? This is Holly Lindsay.
Mm-hmm.
Tell him to call me.
I'm at his cabin.
Okay. Can I have the phone number?
Well, it's his cabin.
Look, I get in trouble if I don't leave a number with it.
Oh, of course.
815 area code 555. 6791.
Okay, thank you.
What am I gonna do? What is it possibly gonna take to convince you?
If you just listen.
No. Look, I've listened enough, all right? You sober up your con artist ex lover, you dress him up, you fly him in from Europe.
To pawn
himself off as my father.
He is your father. You deserve better, I agree.
Give me a break.
I thought we'd reached an understanding when you brought me the present at Christmas. The song of Blue Jacks you had framed, it was such a lovely gesture.
So what if I did?
Then you admit it?
It didn't mean anything. I just felt sorry for you, all right?
It means you have doubts.
Oh, no, not the kind of doubts you're talking about.
It's all right. Naturally, you're confused, but you have admitted a connection between us. Have the blood test. That way you'll know for sure, one way or the other.
And what? give you the opportunity to doctor the results?
Why would I do that?
Why? Are you kidding me? I mean, why would you call in a favor and squash my job in New York? Why would you try and ruin my relationship with Melinda?
Nick.
No. There's no way that you're going to destroy all my memories, my entire history with my real parents. So once and for all, just stay out of my life.
Have you even thought about Nick and all of this and what this is doing to him?
The truth is not always what we want or expect.
You really got it down. What, do you and Alexander sit around and quiz each other on the details?
What are you afraid of?
You're just like her. You enjoy this, don't you? You enjoy messing with people's lives.
I'm not at all like Alexandra. Neither is Nick. No, I like to think he takes after me.
Did your mother say anything before she left?
No, she didn't say where she was going.
Well, leave a note or any message at the station? All right, is there some place that either of them talked about that they'd like to go?
No.
I think it's important.
No, they don't go anywhere. No, there's nothing. I'm sorry. What are you going to do?
I was up all night calling in favors, trying to establish an information network. If they buy or they rent anything or they sign their names to anything, I'll know about it.
Using your agency contacts?
What's left of them. And now I'm going to check around and see if they were in contact with anybody else before they left.
Dad, how can you do that? The police will be everywhere. They're... Dad, you have a gun.
Listen, don't worry. I just have to be prepared for everything in case this all goes down. Understand? I need your help.
What do you need me to do?
Come on, this is getting ridiculous. Would you just say something? Are you sure there's somebody in here?
Yeah.
Could they have slipped out the back way?
There's no back way to the storeroom. Now, just hold on.
All right. There's a long way to go for a piece of birch beer.
Hey, Max. Are you Dr. St. John?
Yeah.
Are you? You're Mrs., I think. Soon to be Mrs.
Thanks.
Holly.
Tracked you down.
Something wrong?
Yeah, near disaster. I forgot to tell you to bring syrup for the pancakes.
Are you sure you're not just trying to check up on me?
No, I'm surprised you're still there. Must be busy.
No, not exactly. Listen, I'll explain later. I won't be long.
Can I have that case of birch beer, if you don't mind?
Thank you.
So what do I owe you? Hold it! Get the thing in that knapsack!
Here. I'll be back for my change later.
What time is it?
About 2 minutes since the last time you asked me.
For heaven's sakes, would you stop with the pencil? I just can't take this, man. Where are they?
What did you think was going to happen? That Roger was going to waltz in here early? If he tries anything,
I will be right there.
Why? Where are you going?
I'm going to company.
I think you should. You're getting on my nerves. Sam, what's going on? Flex, what are you doing here?
Well, your niece has told me a very interesting story.
Is it an interesting story about Daniel?
Yeah. You didn't believe me. You wouldn't listen to Harley or me, so I figured you'd listen to Mr. Reed.
Honey, I listened.
Yeah, but you didn't take me seriously, and you still don't.
Look, I checked out Daniel St. John's story. I even checked it out with the Boston authorities. There is no solid evidence that links him to Jean's murder.
Maybe now there is.
Why? What do you mean?
Possible murder weapon. You see, the night Daniel had his big party at the country club, he was gifted with a name plaque for his desk. Something, well, not as cheap as this. Something really nice. Something heavy. Made of marble. Something heavy. On the bottom, felt. On the felt, a bloodstain, which is now being checked out by your boys in the lab.
And how did you get it?
Can't say.
Fletcher, come on.
All right, I'll give you this much. Right now, Nick McHenry is at Daniel's office. He's looking around, taking some pictures so the police can obtain and issue a search warrant.
Yeah. Hello, is Fletcher Reed there?
McHenry, is that you?
Maybe. Who might this be?
It's Ross Marler, and what the hell are you doing?
Hey, Ross, how you doing? Listen, can I speak to Fletcher, please?
You are interfering with a criminal investigation.
Really? Right now? Which investigation is that, Ross?
Look, did you go to Dr. St. John's office?
Yeah, I did. You see, I have this pain in my neck. It's kind of a shooting pain. You ever get that?
Never mind. Fletcher.
Oh, for me? My partner. Did you get the pictures?
No, the plaque wasn't there.
Peachy.
Listen, know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go over to Daniel St. John's lab and see if it turned up there. I'll call you if I
find it.
All right, good. You do that.
All right, what was that about?
Nick, please. Alex, are you okay? Would it be so terrible to have me for a mother?
No, of course not, but you have to put yourself in his place. I mean, he doesn't want to hurt you. He just loves the woman who raised him.
But she's not his mother. I am.
Alex.
I'm sure of it now. I tracked Eric down in Paris.
Eric Lemonicek? You mean to tell me he's alive?
Oh, very much so. And he confessed that I did give birth to twins, and he took one of the boys. He sold one of my sons.
Oh, my God. How could he do that?
He says he was overwhelmed. He was worried about his career and didn't want to be dragged down by a family. It all makes sense now, but Nick won't believe it.
Well, Alex, I can't imagine what you're going through right now. But you have to realize that you're talking about Nick's whole life.
I know.
Lily.
Ed. Oh, Ed. You're just the man I'm looking for. You can help me.
Lillian and I have some business to discuss.
No, that's all right. I want to hand in these requisition forms. Go ahead.
I'm trying to prove Nick McHenry is my son. Ed, did you hear me?
I'm sorry. That's between the two of you, isn't it?
It's become a medical matter. Isn't it true blood tests can prove paternity?
Up to a point, they can. Look, for example, if you and the supposed father are A positive and Mr. McHenry is B negative, then that effectively rules you out as being parents.
Or rules out the people who raised him.
Hmm?
Well, that would be a start.
Excuse me, would you? You called the hospital in Clayton?
Yes, I did, and they'll call me as soon as the bed's available. Now, look, I did the OR schedules for the next 2 months. I handed in the standard requisition forms early. Marcia said if there's anything else, she'll have
to... I'm not going to need Marcia. You're going to be here for all of this.
Well, just in case.
Lillian, you're going in for surgery. It's not...
I know, and I know the statistics.
You're going to be fine, and it's important to go in with a good frame of mind.
I am, really. I just want to keep busy, so I've been doing all these things. Okay. In my mind, I've been going over all the different scenarios. You know, the words that you and I toss around every day in this clinical, precise way. Well, those words, when they're about your body and your life.
Look, you caught this very early. Your doctor is optimistic that a radical procedure will not be necessary.
I'm sorry. I wasn't going to do this.
Look, I don't want you to think that you have to pretend around me.
Thank you. I don't know what I'd do without you. Now, I'm going to go get back to work. You really think this is going to work?
time it just right. What?
I just don't like this. It looks bad you running like this.
I can't leave this to the police. I don't give a damn what they think.
What if Mom is already married to Daniel?
I don't think they've had time yet, but it really doesn't matter. The important thing is I get to her.
Then what?
I'll work it out when the time comes. Listen, last night, your mother was ready to walk away from Daniel. She did a complete turnaround, and she realized I doctored the tape and set him up. But there was this moment of realization, and I saw it. And more importantly, Daniel saw it.
What makes you think she's going to believe you now? She is furious about what you did.
That's fine. That's fine. As long as she just focuses on her anger toward me, she'll be just fine. It's when she lets her doubts about Daniel show to him that he's a danger to her.
Yeah.
You understand? You're going to take some heat from the police.
I can handle it.
I know. I just hate involving you in all this. But you're the only one I can trust anymore.
I have waited a long time for you to realize that.
I know.
Especially after I found out about you and Mandy, I didn't know what to think.
You're my daughter, and I love you. And that's forever. Okay? You're gonna hear some rotten things about me. Just know that I'm doing this for your mother. You were right. I love her. And at this point, it doesn't really matter what she feels or doesn't feel about me. I've got to save her from that maniac.
Please just be careful.
You ready? Let's do it. Well, just don't worry. It's going to be okay.
No, it stinks. It's not fair. But I know that they will realize you're innocent.
Come here. Listen, I'm going to go back to the apartment, pick up some things before I head over to the police station, okay?
Okay. Do you want me to call Ross and the detective and tell them you're on your way?
No. I'll be there on time.
All right.
Give me a kiss. Give me a smile. Bye.
To leave, I will.
Why must you look at me as the enemy?
Because you're hurting the man I love. Alexandra brought you here to keep her fantasy alive.
I came on my own.
With what?
I cashed in on some valuables Alexandra gave me in Paris for airfare. That's true. But even she was surprised when I showed up. I came to see Nick.
Am I supposed to believe you? A man who gave one son away and claims to have sold the other one to a stranger?
You're right. You have no reason to believe me. I've made some terrible mistakes. But I paid. I lost my sons, too.
But Nick is not your son. And I knew Lou Jack, and I saw the results of what you did to him. So how can you use his memory like this? Aren't you ashamed?
I am. But you don't know the whole story. I tried to see Lou Jack growing up as often as I could. He didn't believe that, but it's true. And as far as Nick goes, I tried to find him when he was about 5 years old. I'd finished a very successful tour. My recordings were selling well, so I used the money to try and find the people who were raising him. But it was just one dead end after another.
Am I supposed to feel sorry for you? Because I feel nothing but disgust. For you and for Alexandra. And all this talk you have about these feelings you have for Nick. If you care so much about him, then why can't you just leave him alone?
I want my son back.
Well, what if he doesn't want you? Even if you were his father. Never mind.
Don't you think? I knew this is how you'd react. How he'd react. Why would I even bother?
Oh, I'm sure that Alexandra promised you the moon. But I wouldn't hold my breath, Mr. Lavonicek, because it doesn't mean anything.
Alexandra hurt you somehow, didn't she? I mean, before the trouble with Nick.
I'll be damned if I'm going to discuss my personal life with you.
What are you doing here together?
Oh, my. Looks like you bought out the store.
Oh, God. They had all this stuff that I remember from when I was a kid.
Mary Beth's preserves?
Oh, yeah. My uncle used to give that to me every Christmas. You know, I miss times like that. Everything was so simple.
No, they weren't. You just didn't know any better.
You know, I've been thinking, maybe we ought to hold off on calling Ed.
No, I already did. I left him a message at the hospital.
Well, I hope we can keep a secret.
Sure. It's better. I want him to know we're here.
Well, we got food, shelter, firewood. Guess we got everything we need, huh?
Yeah.
Almost. Here.
Mm.
It's a wedding band.
I can see what it is. It's beautiful.
I went out and got it the day after I proposed to you. You know, I was willing to wait for you as long as you needed, but I'm awfully glad things worked out the way they did. I am so incredibly happy with you. I don't want this to ever end.
I don't have anything for you. I'm sorry. We'll have to answer suddenly.
No, I don't care. I have everything that I want. Right here. And I got a list. A little list of some ministers and one justice of the peace, and I'm going to make a few phone calls and see who's available.
Oh, I'll do that.
I'm so happy it's just the two of us up here. You know, no family, no distractions, and all that garbage we left. I think this is better. I mean, Roger would just make a scene. This way, he can't bother us. He's never going to touch us again.
Where is he? And how come he came back to this building?
Well, he said something to his daughter about picking up some things. So I followed him and I beat him inside. He parked his car on this level. I can watch it from over here.
Why didn't you grab him?
Well, I thought, who knows? I mean, what if he meets someone or tries to dump the murder weapon or something? I mean, we could catch a break. I mean, he could get sloppy right down to the wire.
His time was up 10 seconds ago. I arrest him as soon as he gets here, and I don't like the fact that he was out of your sight even for a minute. Come on. Go, go. There he is. Let's get a sweep. Let's see what he does. He's just sitting there. Something's wrong. Come on. Great. Just great. That son of a...
In a coat on a cold night and driving my father's car?
For aiding and abetting a fugitive from justice.
The last time I saw my father, he was on his way to turn himself in.
Oh, I am sorry. What a great show. The big send-off. I fell for it.
Forget it. You are in deep trouble, baby. You better start talking now.
Didn't anybody ever tell you it's rude to point your finger, baby?
I got a warrant for your old man's arrest. Murder one, and that makes you an accessory after the fact.
My father may be a lot of things, but he's not a murderer.
Then why did he run? Now, where is he?
Yeah. You better cooperate now.
I have no clue.
Okay, but if you did, you'd tell us, right? Go call in, tell him to check the airports and the trains. You know the drill.
Right.
You already have him tried and convicted, don't you? Just like the other small minds in this town. People don't like my father, so they'll let him rot in jail for something he didn't do. I don't care what you have against my father. You're a police officer. I guess that doesn't mean anything. You're no better than the rest of them.
Oh, but you are, right? You think the law only applies to other people. Boy, your daddy taught you real well.
Why would he do it? Did you ask yourself that?
Yeah, have you?
Yes, if you'd open your eyes, you'd realize that he has been telling the truth the entire time. He didn't kill Gene Wetherill. Daniel St. John did. He's the one you should be going after.
Thanks for the eye-opener.
Okay, all set.
Can I go now?
Yeah, but don't leave town. Put a tail on her.
Right.
No, I appreciate it. That will be fine. Yeah, I'll be there as soon as I can. Thanks. Ed? That was the hospital in Clayton. They have a bed available. Joanne said she'll cover for me. I'd like to get this over with as soon as I can.
Okay. I'll clear my schedule and I'll drive you there.
Thank you. I just have to collect my things.
Do you have any messages?
Well, yes. Actually, your wife called. I mean, Aunt Maureen.
What'd she say?
Something about Michelle's dance recital.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Anything else? I mean, anything urgent?
No, nothing urgent.
Okay, I'll pick them up later.
Not for me, you won't.
Excuse me. I'm looking for Dr. Bauer. I was just at his office. He wasn't there. Do you know where I might find him?
Yeah, well, he left, probably for the day. Excuse me, I'm getting to my patient.
Yeah, Springfield Company. It's a restaurant. Excuse me. Yes, go on. Yeah, is there a Melinda Lewis there? It's an emergency.
What do you think you're doing?
What I do is none of your business. So stay out of my life, Phoenix.
You have no business talking to that creature. How many years is it going to take me to realize you can't be trusted?
I don't like being told what to do.
As long as we have a contract, you'll do exactly as I say.
I'll just go back to Paris.
You haven't earned the advance I gave you yet.
You want this so badly, you're not even making sense anymore. How do you expect Nick to respond?
He's having trouble facing the truth.
So you're going to try shoving it down his throat?
Oh, I don't expect you to understand.
I used to understand you better than anyone.
Things change.
Nick's my son, too. All you've done is to drive him further and further away. You've got to stop trying to control him.
It's not easy undoing the mess you've made.
Look at you, Alexandra. Why are you so alone? Why have you alienated so many people?
I don't have to take this from you.
You'd better. If you want your son to have any feelings for you other than resentment, I know how to get to him. If I can make friends with this lady...
What are you talking about?
This lady, if I can make friends with her... Let me ask her to join us.
Absolutely not. I said no, Eric.
I gather you and Melinda have some unpleasant history.
It's none of your business.
Whatever happened to the girl I loved? Why have you become so hard? So bitter?
It might have something to do with having both of my sons stolen from me.
Fine. If you'll excuse
me. No, there's one more thing. What is your blood type?
I have no idea.
Then we'll find out. and we'll find out the blood types of the people who raised Nick, Kip, and Mary McHenry. It's the only way to convince him.
No. You're going about this all wrong.
You don't have a choice. Either you do as I say, or you will never set foot in a concert hall again. And don't think I can't do it.
I'm warning you. You leave her alone.
Well, Linda's a big girl. She can talk to me on the phone if she chooses.
She chooses not to.
Look, it's important. You let her decide 2 minutes. It's all I need.
What about what she needs?
Look, I'm not going to upset her.
Oh, upset her? Is that what you call it? You put her through hell, pal. She was all alone. She needed somebody, and you took advantage. You used her.
That's not what happened.
And then you just left.
Believe what you want. I don't have time.
Just to let you know, Melinda's not alone anymore. She's not vulnerable. And she has no desire to see or speak with you.
You through?
Don't call, you don't write, and don't even try and see her. Now I'm through.
Mindy?
Oh, have you seen my father?
No, not since you were together. Why?
It's not important.
Blake Wade. Look, I just wanted to say that I know you might think that I was using you to get close to your father last year, but it's more than that. I really did consider you a friend.
Oh, that's good to hear.
So that something's wrong.
Yeah. It is. It's personal.
Okay.
My parents are in a lot of trouble.
Look, I meant what I said, and it's really nothing against you, but I don't think I can find anything resembling sympathy for your father.
What about my mother?
Holly, yeah. I like Holly. I'm designing a wedding dress for her.
Well, I don't think she's going to be needing it. She and Daniel eloped.
Kidding. She didn't say anything. She didn't even call.
Then she might. Listen, if she does call you, make sure that you get her phone number and where she's staying. Find all that out,
okay,
please.
Hi, Blake. Excuse us for a second, please.
Sorry.
I just ran into Roger Thorpe at the hospital. He was trying to contact you.
What?
I overheard him trying to track you down here.
Well, why would he want to talk to me?
I don't know. I didn't ask. I just made it very clear that I didn't want him bothering you.
Nick, look, he knows I just hang up on him. Don't worry about it. I'm sure he won't try it again.
Well, I'm not, okay? Listen, I want you to do me a favor. I'm not going to be able to go home with you right now. I have to go to the police station. Can you just wait for me? Go to the house, lock the door, put on the answering machine. Don't let anybody in.
Nick.
No, listen, just do it for me, all right? Just tonight. I don't put anything past this guy. Promise me.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. I'll see you.
All right, thank you. Lab will have the test results in a matter of minutes.
I just hope Nick got a picture of that plaque.
We're going to need something a bit more than a piece of felt with blood on it, Fletch.
I wonder where he is.
So you believe me now?
Sammy, if that test comes back positive, Daniel has a lot of questions to ask. And I owe you an apology. I thought you were doing this for all the wrong reasons, Sammy. Treated you like a lovesick teenager. Mm. You deserve better.
Thank you. What's important now is we get to the truth.
So where's Roger?
Gabe Levy, the slip.
Now look, what happened?
His daughter helped him pull it fast at the last minute. You know, we should have never given Roger those extra 3 days. He should have been thrown right in jail, because now he's gone.
Wait a minute, I just saw him.
Where?
At the hospital.
The hospital? And you let him get away?
Well, I'm sorry. I wasn't under the impression that you needed our assistance.
Now look, come here. Look, it turns out that Roger may not be our man after all.
What are you talking about?
Well, tomorrow's come.
What?
Have those test results.
Oh,
thank you, Kevin. What is this?
Well?
Blood on a piece of felt matches Gene Wetherill.
What piece of felt? Something Roger has?
No, it's a name plaque belonging to Daniel St. John.
Oh, hey. That guy that was in here before me?
Hold on.
Here's your change.
Oh, thanks. I need to find him. I need to find out where he's staying.
Uh-huh.
See, I can't explain it to you, but it's very, very important. Do you know all the people around here who rent cabins?
Yeah.
Well, I need to find that Dr. St. John. What about him? Where's he staying?
I never saw him before today. I don't know where he's staying. I don't remember anyone renting to a St. John. No, he's not on my list.
Well, Lindsay, maybe? Lindsay, possibly?
No Lindsay either. See, we got Adam, Allison, Atwater, Bailey, Bannington, Bauer.
Bauer?
Connelly.
Oh, I thought you left already.
No, I'm leaving now. If Maureen should call again, would you just tell her that I had to go look after a patient?
Sure.
Thanks. Mm-hmm. Take care of everything?
Everything I could think of. I'm as ready as I'll ever be, I guess.
Oh, Ed, I'd like you to do the blood test on Eric now, the matter we discussed.
Oh, I'm sorry. Look, this really isn't a good time for him, but any intern can do it for you.
I thought you understood. This is personal. I want you to handle it.
All right, I will, but you're going to have to make an appointment. Excuse me.
Rare treat. Watching you not get your way. Pity any man who dares to cross you.
Yeah.
Hey, it's me.
How'd it go?
Everything's fine. Guess who I ran into? Mindy Lewis. She was supposed to be designing Mom's wedding dress, remember?
I remember. Good thinking, honey. I had the same thought myself. I'll be in touch.
So Roger's not our only suspect after all. We have to get St. John in here asking a few questions.
Well, we've already got enough to go pick up the plaque.
Oh, man, we seem to be way ahead of you guys. I've already been to his office, to the lab, and to his apartment. The plaque is gone.
Harley. She must have kept it. She was going to return it after she talked to Holly.
What? What did she do?
She followed Holly and Danny when they took off.
Sam, where did they go?
I don't know. She called me from the road, but she couldn't say where she was.
Give me dispatch.
What are you going to do?
Put an APB in her car and then Holly and Daniel's. We gotta find Harley before she finds St. John, because if he did kill Gene Wetherill, Harley's in deep trouble.
That was one of the ministers.
And?
How do you feel about getting married today?
Are you serious?
He's on his way over.
Oh, baby. Prepare to have your last breakfast as a free woman. Tomorrow morning, you're gonna be Mrs. Daniel St. John.
This has been Guiding Light.